So I began to crawl on my hands and knees to the kitchen, down the hall from my bedroom. I kept having to stop and place my face against the cool floor tiles so I wouldn't faint. Everything was out of focus and I was experiencing double vision. I had just about reached the kitchen when I heard John call out in pain. As I entered the doorway, I could see this large man had John pinned to the kitchen counter, his arms around John's waist and back, holding him from behind. They seemed to be struggling. I staggered to my feet. It was dark. The kitchen light was off. They were illuminated only by the light from the window. I saw this hammer on the floor. But I swung at the man, attacking John. Just as I did so, they both turned, startled by my presence, and the hammer struck John and shattered his temple. He must have died instantly. I don't remember anything else.
And I was about to get up when he pulled out a package of cigarettes and he said, "Would you like a cigarette?" And I said, "No thanks, I'm trying to stop smoking." "Well, just one won't hurt you. Why don't you just have one with me?" he said, and he started walking towards me with the cigarette package out. And I said, "No, really, I really am trying to stop smoking, and one will do it, and I don't want one, thanks." And he came right up and stood beside me, and I remember being puzzled by what he was doing and maybe also a bit afraid of him, because I remember looking up at him sort of with my mouth open when he said, "But I really like you," and he leaned over and he put his arm around my shoulders, sort of like comrades or something, and then he bent over and he kissed me. I mean, really kissed me with his tongue in my mouth. And when he stopped that, he stood up and said, "Let's go to bed right now. I want to fuck you." I said, "You're crazy. It's impossible. And besides, you've made a mistake." And he said, "Why?" I said, "Well, for one thing, my girlfriend's just down that hallway right behind that door. So, you're crazy." By this time, he was fondling my crotch. He said, "Well, we'll just go to the bathroom then. It won't take long, because I'm really hot." "You're crazy," I said. What Nancy described as a cry of pain from me was not entirely that. I'm sure she meant to kill us both.